Happy Heads campaign. We're asking you to volunteer for charities that support children and young people. Among the organisations is Daisy Inclusive, a disability-led charity based in Everton that helps to support disabled and vulnerable children, adults and families. Dave Kelly is the founder and MD and joins me now. Hello, Dave.
Hello, Paul. Hello, listeners.
Tell us a bit more about the charity and how long ago did you start it?
Well, it was started around about 2004, initially. And it started off that I went blind about 27 years ago. And because of the lack of things for me to do and support that I got at the time, and I was isolated for 3 years, and I kind of set it up, Daisy, as a place for people to come, feel safe and happy, regardless of abilities or disabilities. And with the focus of taking the dis out of disability, I focus on people's abilities. And we use like sport as a medium, education, employment, and basically having a good time, feeling good, like who you are, being happy in your own skin. So no one's judgmental. We just all get stuck in and we help each other. It's funny when I go in, you know, I'm blind, I'm sighted at all. And you know, about 10 people want to guide me through, you know, and that's like anyone who comes in to get all the support you want and wish for. And I suppose it's with the volunteers we're talking about now is training them up and giving them opportunity to help the most vulnerable in our society. And I tell you what, the buzz you get out of helping people is amazing. It's like a drug, you know, the more you help people, the more satisfaction you get because you're doing a good thing for our community. So yeah, anyone who's out there, come and sign up.
Yeah, so what kind of activities and projects do you engage and support young people in?
We have our Smile Initiative, which is self-motivation, inclusive learning and empowerment, and we have the mini Smile, which is for the younger ones, and the bigger Smile, which is for like the over 18s. And it's through sport, getting people, you know, through singing, through, you know, like lots of vocational work. We do, you know, independent living and how to just, you know, taking care of our bodies and our minds, because, geez, after 18 months of the pandemic, I think a lot of people are struggling, both emotionally, mental health is ripe at the moment, and we can see a big increase. So it'll be helping people, supporting people just to talk to someone, and, you know, because loneliness is a terrible thing. It's probably one of the biggest killers, actually. And so when people come to Daisy, you know, no one's lonely, and it's like for any volunteers that come in, where they can just sit down and have a chat to someone, have a talk, support them throughout the day. So we're doing independent living, so we'll be teaching them how to, you know, make food, and even as simple as a cup of tea to, you know, like a lasagna head or whatever. But yeah, it's healthy eating on a budget and stuff like that. So, yeah.
And you know, you talked there about loneliness obviously being a really big problem. Mental health in general, particularly at the moment, how important is that support for young people and the families you work with?
Paul, it's very, very important because, as I say, these young people are the future. I was like, oh, they're like garlic bread, they're the future. And they are. So it's keeping them in a good state of mind and a positive outlook on life rather than, you know, you can't go out and, you know, I mentioned once on your show about fog or fear of going out. And it is so true, and it's getting even more ripe now. But for young people and mental health, it's an epidemic, I'd say. You know, there seems to be an awful lot of people who you need someone to talk to, some specialist help that may not be out there, but it's out there, but you're on a big waiting list for some people. So we have talking groups, discussion groups. So if you nip it in the bud, you know, windows of opportunity, get them from that isolation, kind of doing something positive with their lives. And if you watch, you know, help someone who's in a wheelchair, you can't see, who's got learning difficulties, and that is like therapeutic for any young person, especially when, you know, when they're taught how to do it. And it's not like you throw them a room with 20 disabled people and get on with it. We don't do that at days. We slowly introduce them, and let them feel part of the group and get to know everyone and understand disability. Don't be scared of disability. You know, unfortunately, as humans, we're a bit scared of people who are different, what colour someone's skin or sexuality or the way people walk, talk. Or so we teach young people like not to be scared of it, of disability. In fact, some of the greatest people on this planet may have a disability, you know, from autism to physical to blindness. So, you know, just, you know, fight the fear through a bit of knowledge and, you know what, fun. You know, to hear someone laugh is like medicine in itself, isn't it? Mm. Someone who's been, like, stuck in the house for a while or, you know, and through all the, you know, the Halloween issues that they've been going through, but when you can get them laughing again and get them talking, get them coming out more regular, do physical activity, fit body, fit mind, there we go. We can make a big difference out there.
Dave, have you had to adapt a lot in the last year about how you work, obviously, with the pandemic?
Oh, yeah. We had to, you know, all policies, procedures. But I was looking for every loophole to stay open, whereas, unfortunately, I know some charities have to close down, and that's unfortunate. But I thought we need to be there for the people, you know, when they need us the most. And that was my big thing, to encourage all our staff to come on, let's come in, let's carry on going. And we adapted to delivering the much-needed food parcels and necessities, and we got it. And we didn't charge for them, by the way, Paul. We give them to people who needed the most, because poverty, people coming out of work and things. So, you know, didn't want to be seen as, making money from this terrible thing. So we give it all away. We helped hundreds and hundreds of families over the past 18 months. And, once again, giving them a place to come then. We're doing lots of mindfulness activities, lots of crisis, counselling. So seeing it for ourselves, you know, because we're out on that front line, all the issues and problems that we're there now, and we're going to be there for the future. This mental health, as I say, that's a big one.
You're part of our Happy Heads campaign, and we're encouraging people to volunteer whatever time they have to give. What type of tasks are you hoping for people to sign up to do?
Yeah, well, we've got like our sports side of it, where they can come in and volunteer doing the sports, or like from football, even blind football, wheelchair activities, goalball, walking, running, that type of thing. Just supporting someone, teaching them out, getting them down the track or into a wheelchair, out of a wheelchair. Just these little tasks like that. Doing independent living, so helping someone, kind of prepare food, helping someone get the ingredients to put something together. IT, so just be with someone. We're going to buddy people up so they feel comfortable with whatever they're doing. We're giving a go trying all different things. We do loads of music, for example. We do music. We do lots of singing. And hopefully the Daisy Choir will be in Liverpool one soon. Well, it's going to be another 4 weeks now. I've been told, but you know what?
Well, yes.
Unfortunately. So we'll start. Well, I'll tell you what, with all this practice that we're doing, we're going to be brilliant when we do. Actually,
you'll be the best performance ever, Dave. The best performance ever. Lovely speaking with you. Thank you for coming on.
Thank you, Paul.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye, bye-bye. That's Dave Kelly there, who's the founder and MD of Davesy Inclusive UK. And if you're interested in volunteering, then go to bbc.co.uk/make-a-difference. Click on Happy Heads for a list of Merseyside charities that need volunteers. Davesy Inclusive UK is right at the top of that list.